When I was a kid, I used to love watching surf films. And one of the things that was really cool about those films was that they were shot on 16mm film using these really cool old Bolex cameras. And it was really expensive to do. And really expensive to do nowadays, if not nearly impossible for somebody like me or maybe you on an indie budget. But there are really cool things about the aesthetic of film that we've been all working hard towards achieving that we can implement into our digital files. And one of those things are light leaks. Now, what are light leaks? That's a light leak. And we're gonna make those today. So first, let's talk about how they happen. What causes a light leak? Now, with those old cameras, with the film door, however you access the inside of the camera, some of that stuff would wear out over time, and slowly but surely, little bits of light would leak into the camera. It wouldn't completely ruin the film or the shot, but you could see it on the film. It was exposing portions of the film. Sometimes it was cool, but at this period of time, when light leaks were happening, it really wasn't like that awesome. People weren't stoked about it like we're stoked about it now. The cool thing is we can create these light leaks independently, separate from our actual digital files, since we can't really light leak during recording, or can we? And we can implement those light leaks that we create on top of our actual clean video files. So let's dig in and let's do that. But first, let's talk about some of the things you're gonna need to get this done. The first and most important is a camera that can record without its lens on, which means you need a camera that you can remove the lens. So that's first one. Does your camera have a removable lens? If so, bing, let's move on to step two. Step two, can your camera record without the lens on? Some cameras will say, sorry, there's no lens, can't do it. But fear not, most cameras that kick up those errors have an option to disable that error and you can record without lens. So if you can do those two things, and you can find a dark space to record, and you can kick up a myriad of light sources, then you too, my friend, can make light leaks for your video productions. First, let's go into a dark space. And my camera is set up on its tripod. Now, while it's recording, you move and tilt and shift the lens in various ways while introducing a extraneous light source, my personal favorite, is a cigarette lighter. You'll see with the lens in front of the sensor, even with the lens completely out of the equation, it's not hard to make these really cool abstract patterns and shapes with the camera sensor capturing that light. It doesn't really make a lot of sense when you're looking at it, but it's kind of fun to do on its own. But where it really comes into awesome fashion is when you implement it into your nonlinear editor, your video editor. You take that light leak track and you place it over the top of your clean video plate and set that overlay or blending mode to overlay or add and just adjust the opacity. Just do that a little bit to taste and check out your awesome film-like goodness. They're really simple, really easy to make, they add a lot, they work really well for transitions, and they're cheap because, well, if you got all the stuff, it's free. If you don't have the stuff or you don't have the interest in doing that, you can download a few light leaks from my website or a larger pack for a very reasonable deal. Thanks for watching this week's video. We'll catch you next week. A toodaloo.